It's only 85 days for the upcoming Lok Sabha elections. The general election countdown has begun. Just under 90 days now, about 85 days to go until those crucial elections, and a lot happening politically. Political alliances taking place, political rallies taking place. But very interestingly, news just coming in from Uttar Pradesh now. Akhilesh Yadav and BSP Supremo Mayawati will be holding a joint press conference tomorrow, and it is expected that they will make the formal announcement of them coming together. My colleague Alok Pandey now joining us live from Lucknow. Alok, a very good morning, and a very important news coming out this morning about two major supremos coming together. We heard over the weekend that there were source-based inputs about them coming together, but now it is perhaps going to be official tomorrow.
Well, it is, Snigdha. Good morning. And if you also notice that in the last week or so, all the press releases that have come from Mayawati or Akhilesh have mentioned this Gathbandhan. Now, when Akhilesh Yadav faced some questions from the CBI, or CBI sources said that they would question Akhilesh Yadav related to an alleged sand mining scam, at that point, Mayawati had given out a press release to say that she had spoken to Akhilesh, and she specifically mentioned the word Gathbandhan and saying that the BJP is scared of their Gathbandhan. And when Akhilesh issued a press release a few days ago, he also mentioned the same thing. So that gave you the hint that the announcement was all but coming, and that it would come in a few days, and that is what's going to happen tomorrow, as far as we've heard. Though, of course, in politics, you cannot say until it actually happens, but we do believe that that alliance is going to be announced tomorrow. Now, about seat sharing in the alliance, there's still a little doubt about the role of the Congress, but it does seem that as of now, at least the alliance that will be announced will include the Samajwadi party, the Bahujan Samaj party, and smaller parties like the Rashtriya Lok Dal, and perhaps also the Nishad party, which is a party in Eastern UP and holds influence amongst the OBC Nishad caste. One of their candidates won the 2018 Gorakhpur Lok Sabha by-poll, defeating Yogi Adityanath's BJP candidate. It was a seat held by the BJP earlier. The significance of this alliance can be gauged perhaps from a bit of history. If you look at 2014, when Samajwadi Party and the BSP and the Congress all fought separately and the BJP was a dominant force, the BJP and its ally, the Apna Dal, managed to win a whopping massive 73 out of 80 Lok Sabha seats. The BSP was totally decimated. I think they did not win a single Lok Sabha seat. The Samajwadi Party won a few and the Congress won Amethi and Raibareli. So that was the kind of dominance that you saw from the BJP in 2014. This dominance was repeated into the 2017 assembly elections in Uttar Pradesh, when the BJP won a comfortable majority in the UP assembly along with its allies. And again, Yogi Adityanath was installed as the chief minister. Now, if you look at what happened in 2018, there were three crucial Lok Sabha by-elections where the Samajwadi Party, the Bahujan Samaj Party, and its smaller allies, in the case of Gorakhpur in Eastern UP, you had the Nishad Party, they all got together and said that we will fight the elections jointly. When they fought the elections jointly, what happened? The BJP lost all three sitting seats. Gorakhpur was a seat that was held by Yogi Adityanath, who is now chief minister. Phulpur near Allahabad, or Prayagraj, was held by Keshav Prasad Maurya, who was deputy chief minister. And Kairana in Western UP was held by Hukum Singh of the BJP, who died. And now you have an MP there who fought on a Rashtriya Lok Dal ticket, but was also a Bahujan Samaj Party member at some point. So that tells you that if this success story in 2018 were to be replicated on a larger scale, it would be a big headache for the BJP. Right. The BJP has publicly acknowledged, Amit Shah, the party chief, has publicly acknowledged that this is a headache for them. How they are going to, Snigdha, now mount a challenge to this alliance remains to be seen.
Right, Alok, this can be seen as, you know, they're coming together because of political survival. But where does the Congress stand in all this? Will they be part of this Gathbandhan?
Well, Snigdha, it's a little difficult for me to say right now, but I don't think that's happening, given that what we've heard in the last week seems to point out that the only concession that the Samajwadi Party and the BSP are willing to give is the Amethi and Raibareli seats that are currently held respectively by Rahul Gandhi, the Congress president, and his mother, Sonia Gandhi. Beyond that, the SP and the BSP, or their top leaders like Akhilesh and Mayawati, perhaps feel that the Congress does not have a winnability factor in Uttar Pradesh on other seats, and that's why they don't want to give any more seats to. That's the thought within the Samajwadi Party and the BSP, at least that is what some sources will tell you. There are some others who will paint this in a positive light and say that, look, at the end of the day, keeping the Congress out of this alliance also means that the Congress can actually look to it to cut into some upper caste votes of the BJP if they fight independently of more on most seats. This is something that I've heard from a lot of thinkers, analysts who are saying that this, even this is strategy. But if you don't go into whether this is strategy or not, it does seem that at least when the announcement comes in tomorrow, you'll have a situation where the Samajwadi Party, the BSP, and a few smaller parties will get together to form this coalition and say that they're going to mount a challenge to Akhilesh Yadav, to the BJP in Uttar Pradesh.